Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today we are going to do week 4 assignment of ethical hacking course NPTEL. First question is, what is the purpose of hypervisor software? So hypervisor software is a virtual machine monitor. So the answer would be it can create and run multiple virtual machines on a computer system. Second is, what are some of the features in Kali Linux? It is a Debian based Linux distribution that have collection of tools that are used for penetration testing. B part is correct. It is a secure and operating system that has been designed as hack proof. It is not hack proof. It is used for hacking, but it can be hacked as well. It is a software distribution created by the company Kali NC. It is created by 2 person, but it is managed by offensive security. So the answer would be B. Third question is, which of the following statement is are true about passive reconnaissance? So basically, when we are doing passive reconnaissance, we don't directly engage with the target. So information about target is collected indirectly. Second is, there is no direct communication with the target. This is also true, because in active reconnaissance we do direct communication with the target, but in passive we don't do any direct communication. So which of the following can be used for passive reconnaissance? So all of the above, who is archive.org, netcraft searches, all comes under the tools and techniques used for passive reconnaissance. Fifth is, how host discovery can be carried out using ICMP sweep. So the attacker sends out an ICMP echo request packet to the target and waits for an echo reply response. So this A part is the answer of fifth question. Sixth is, how does port scanning using TCP connect work? So basically, there are many types of scans, like TCP sync scan, TCP so basically, in TCP connect scan, we complete the three-way handshake and decide whether the port is open. Seventh, we have, the establishment of a TCP connection involves a negotiation called three-way handshake. Yes, it does. What type of message the client sends to a server in order to begin? So, you know, whenever we are beginning a conversation, we start it by sending a SYN packet, and if the port is open, that is the server is open, it will respond with a packet called SYNACK, and then we will send an acknowledgement packet, and then the connection will be set up. This is three-way handshake. So basically, we send SYN, we receive back SYNACK, and then we respond with acknowledgement that the connection is now working. We want to connect. First is SYN, which means I want to connect. SYNACK means okay, I am open, you can connect, and acknowledgement is okay, I am going to connect to you. Which of the following statement is are true for default networking mode of Oracle VirtualBox? So the default networking mode of Oracle VirtualBox is NAT, which is network address resolution, and it is in this mode an operating system can access internet. Yes, it can. This is basically used for outbound connection, because an outside computer cannot reach to the virtual machine, but this virtual machine can reach to the outside world. It is mostly used for outbound connection. Second is, it allocates it allocates unique IP address to all operating. It does not provide unique IP addresses to all operating. It does not allocate unique IP addresses to operating system, because it makes every virtual system as a standalone system and provides same IP addresses. So it allocates a virtual IP address to all operating systems. So I think B and D are the correct answer for question number 8. Nice. Now we do question number 9. Which of the following can be used to retrieve the deleted data and all the pages available with any website? I think the answer should be archive.org, because it is like a phone book of all the websites ever made. We can see the snapshots of website, how the website used to look in the past, and I think it should be archive.org. Which of the following search operators can narrow down the search results to a specific website? So basically, we are using Google Docs here. So when we are using Google Docs, we can specify this keyword site in order to specify the result to a specific website. What is the purpose of the following nmap command? So the nmap command is nmap-nsn and the IP address. This sn is basically ping scan to see if the host is alive or not. So this is a ping scan. 12th, we have port scanning using TCP SYN scan, how are the open and closed port identified? So attacker sends a SYN packet to the port, and it receives a SYNACK then the port is reported as open. Yes, it is correct. An attacker sends a SYN packet to a port. If it receives an RST that is reset, then the port is reported as closed. So I think this is the correct. These two are the correct options for question number 12. Third, we have by default how many ports are scanned in NMAP. So by default there are 1000 ports scanned whenever we run a simple NMAP scan. 14th is which of the following option can be used for OS and version detection. So basically for version detection we can use -sv flag of NMAP, and for OS detection we can do -o flag, but there is also a aggressive scan which is -a which does all of these. So I think -a should be the answer of this question. Which of the following options can be used for OS and version detection? 15th, which of the following NMAP options can be used to carry out UDB scans? So for carrying out UDB scan we use -su, and if we were doing a TCP scan then it would be st. For port scanning using stealth scan we can so basically it is asking us how can we specify the start the port scanning using when we are doing the stealth scan we can how can we do the port scanning. So we can use the -p option to specify the port. Which of the following NMAP scanning options will scan less number of ports as compared to the default scanning? So we know that in default scanning we do 1000 ports, top 1000 ports scanned, and we can this -f option is fast which scans top 100, -p 20 to 100 which is 80 ports, and then it is also specifying 4 ports. So I think these 3 are the answers. Let us say port number 80 and 443 are open for target system, then there is a high probability that the target is hosting website. Yes, it is, because it is HTTP and 443 is HTTPS. Can the use of firewall prevent host port host scanning? Yes, it is true. So that completes my assignment of week 4 for NPTEL ethical hacking, and thank you for watching.